Hey guys, today I'm going to show you how to do atomic UX research in Considerly. Atomic UX research is a framework for making knowledge management in user research easier. It organizes what you know about your users by splitting information up into small atomic units. So what you see here is our atomic UX research model. It's a slight adaptation from what you might have seen from Thomas Chiron and the Polaris framework. You might also have heard about nuggets, which in our adapted model are facts or rather insights. But stay with me here. I think this will get clearer when we do an example. So let's quickly jump over that model you see here. In the beginning, you have experiments. So everything we do to collect data like research studies. From these experiments, we draw facts. These are, for example, user quotes or statistics, which are just non-debatable pieces of data. By combining and interpreting those facts, we learn something new and gain insights, which in turn reveal opportunities for how we could improve. So for example, we asked 5 users about our new app. We found out that they had issues creating an account. Thereby, we learned that our app's onboarding process is, well, hard to follow, so we could improve by creating an easier step-by-step guide. And then the cycle starts from the beginning with new experiments to confirm our assumptions or these new hypotheses. So this was a rather quick look at the Atomic UX research model. We also have a blog post in our blog on Considerly/blog. If you want to learn more about this framework and have a deep dive. Now let's do a practical example following the Atomic UX research framework in Considerly. Let's imagine you want to do research on a fitness app that suggests exercises you can do in a gym. So here's our project. All of your experiment's data is stored in different nodes. So you have conducted several experiments, and remember that's the first stage of the Atomic UX research model. And these experiments include an online questionnaire and also a lab session. Now, when going through your notes, you will find different things that catch your eye. For example, here, Zoe said that she likes to work out outdoors 2 times a week. Now, that's a fact. This is a direct user quote. That's something Zoe told us, so we cannot argue against it. It's a non-debatable piece of data. And this is exactly the atomic unit on which Atomic UX research builds upon. Now, to add context and structure to this fact, you can apply tags. You could apply tags for emotions or the customer journey or demographics, giving it a priority and so on. So here as an example, I will apply the tag workout frequency. And also I will create a new tag, gym alternative. And as I see here, she prepares for a marathon. So I will also create a new tag for running. So you can apply as many tags as you like and care about organizing them later on. Based on this quote, I just got the insight that users partly do their workout outside the gym. So I'm going to create a new insight and attach this quote to it. And I call the insight, users do parts of their workout outside the gym. When going through your data, you might find other suitable quotes. So, for example, here another user says that he prefers other kind of sports than going to the gym in summer. And again, we applied tag gym alternative, also running, and I will create a new tag, bouldering, as a alternative sports for out doing outside. So again, I will add this quote to the insight we've just created. Now let's have a look at our insights so far. Insights are your findings, your observations, which you can support by evidence like user quotes. So this way you have your facts considered in context and you can draw conclusions from them. Now I added some structure to this insight. So we have here our quotes, which led us to the opportunity, for example, that creating a special category for outdoor activities in our app could reduce users churning in summer. And here we can document potential new experiments, for example, getting to know the users that like to do outdoor sports, focusing on their outdoor activities, and so on. So having documented this opportunity, we've gone through one cycle of the Atomic UX research framework, giving us an insight document here that you can use to present or share. So to sum it up, we've conducted several experiments to collect data, found out about our users' behavior, we connected the facts to this insight, and concluded the opportunity to fill that gap with a special outdoor workouts. So from here, you can always trace your process of thought right back to the raw data. And by creating and publishing insights, you will gradually build up your research repository with a body of research that you can rely upon over time and utilize for new research questions. So if you still have questions, you can always contact us on how to set up your own research repository for this kind of continuous learning and long-term benefits. And of course, you can also try out Considerly for yourself in our 30 days full feature trial.